Nottinghamshire go top with innings win. Nottinghamshire had impressed with the ball on days 1 and 2, but when it came to their turn with the bat, things didn't quite go to plan. Hamid and Duckett had batted their side into a 100-run lead, but Notts would have to cope without the latter. His participation in the match brought to an end by an impromptu England call-up, positive COVID test leaving the national squad in disarray. That meant Dane Schadendorf was handed a debut in unusual circumstances. Not that he would mind, straight into the firing line mere hours after being told he'd be in the squad. And he coped with the unorthodox scenario well, but lost his partner. Finn Hudson-Prentice with his maiden five-fer when Hutton was out LBW for 23. Another good return in the match for the Derbyshire bowler after top scoring with the bat. Brief showers disrupted play, but Notts coped with the minor delay. 300 on the board soon after, the lead up to 150, and the host's position of superiority solidifying. Fletcher added 14 before he fell to Aitchison. Notts down to their last wicket now. And the final wicket stand wouldn't be a long one. Schadendorf the final man to fall, bowled by Rees, and Nottinghamshire all out for 307, their lead 158, 11 more than Derbyshire's first innings total. The departure of Duckett was a real blow for Nottinghamshire. He looked to be the key man for the hosts when he finished the day unbeaten on 69. His replacement Schadendorf should be proud of how he coped in unprecedented circumstances though. Hudson-Prentice will look back fondly on this game. His first five-fer had given Derbyshire a window of opportunity. But they'd find themselves on the back foot in what remained before lunch. Fletcher with an early scalp, Wood out for three, and Derbyshire headed into the interval at 13 for one. Rees and Guest managed to push the score into the 30s before Notts struck again. Guest caught behind for Schadendorf's maiden take in first-class cricket, and the innings was starting to feel reminiscent of their first knock. Deploy stuck with Rees though. The pair were trying to take some of the sting out of the Nottinghamshire attack, and they inched their way towards 50 runs. They couldn't get there though. Deploy bowled by Patterson with just 4 required. Critchley did get them to 50, but it wouldn't be long before Notts had another. Rees, LBW for 21 to Patterson. Critchley replied to the loss of his partner by firing 3 boundaries from 1 Joey Everson over. He and Hossain dragged them to the halfway point in their search for parity. His knock took Derbyshire to 100 runs, but that's where it came to an end. Joey Everson found Critchley's edge, and the all-rounder had to go. Tea taken with the fall of the wicket, Derbyshire still trailing by 58. Hudson-Prentice only could add 9 from his 70 deliveries before he fell in unfortunate circumstances to Fletcher, strangled down the leg side, 4 wickets left and Derbyshire still 43 behind. Thompson's departure left them with 3, another for Fletcher. Patterson kept up the momentum, Cohen out for a duck after 5 balls. Hossain was the last recognised batsman to fall, LBW to Fletcher for his 4th, and Derbyshire were crumbling towards a likely innings defeat unless their 10th wicket partners could find 36 runs. They couldn't. The resistance lasted just 2 balls. Scrimshaw caught behind, and Notts had sealed a massive win. The margin an innings and 36 runs, and Fletcher finished with a well-deserved 5 wicket haul for his efforts. The result keeps Derbyshire as the only side in the LV County Championship without a win, while Nottinghamshire are now the leaders of Group 1. They'll hope they can cling on to their position when they travel to Emirates Riverside next week. Derbyshire have one more chance to pick up a group stage win, but it's far from straightforward. Essex the visitors to the Ancora County Ground next time out.